Welcome everyone. In the previous video in this series on Archimedes on the sphere and cylinder, we looked at the basics of his method for dealing with curved areas and saw how he measured the surface areas of cylinders and isosceles cones. And that leaves us in a position now to move on to one of his most important results, that the surface area of a sphere is 4 times the area of the circle through its equator. So, a sphere is, of course, what you get when you rotate a circle around one of its diameters. So just as Archimedes used a diagram with a circle sandwiched between two regular polygons, so in this case, he uses that diagram rotated around a diameter. And in my example here, I've used dodecagons. It's important that the number of sides is divisible by 4. And for now, to keep things simpler, we're just going to focus on the sphere and the shape formed by rotating the inner polygon. We'll add the outer one later. So this shape inscribed in the sphere, it's got cones at either end, and otherwise it's made of a set of what you might call cone slices. In other words, the bit of a cone between two planes, which are both perpendicular to the cone's axis. And this is one of the key shapes Archimedes is going to use to calculate the surface area of a sphere. You might like to just pause the video briefly and think how you would work out this surface area given what we've seen so far about Archimedes' methods. So Archimedes actually has a particularly cute way of deriving a formula for this area using actually a real favourite diagram from Euclid. So suppose we've got a cone with the apex O cut by planes where the circular sections have radii AB and CD. We saw in the previous video that the surface area of the cone down to C is proportional to OC times CD, whereas the surface area of the cone just down to A is proportional to OA times AB. So how can we get a handle on the value of OC times CD minus OA times AB? And to an ancient Greek, this question just cries out for us to complete a parallelogram. OCD, and then completed at P, and then we draw in the lines through B parallel to the sides of the parallelogram. And this sort of arrangement within a parallelogram, we've got lines parallel to the sides intersecting on the diagonal of the parallelogram. That features in Euclid's Elements, and it's shown there a neat result that the smaller parallelograms that sort of face each other across B have equal area. I'll leave that to you to consider. It's relatively simple with similar triangles. Since the area of all these parallelograms in the figure here is in a constant proportion to the product of their sides, we can say that OC times CD minus OA times AB is this area, a sort of backwards L shape, which can be described as AC times CD plus this parallelogram, which is equal to AC times AB. So in modern terms, what we find out is that the surface area of the cone slice is pi, that's the factor that we have to add in now, multiplied by AC, so the side of the cone that's left, multiplied by CD plus AB, the sum of the radii at the top and bottom. And Archimedes, without having a symbol for pi, had to phrase it slightly differently as being an area equal to a circle whose radius is the geometric mean of AC and CD plus AB. So this formula now allows us to tackle adding up the surface area of the whole shape inscribed in the sphere. And again, if you feel like it, this is a good place to pause and just see if you could use this formula to form such a sum. So to put it in simple terms, in each zone, the area is pi times the side length of the polygon, which is the same all the way around because it's a regular polygon, multiplied by the top plus the bottom radius. So overall, we've got pi times the side length of the polygon, that bit's the same in every bit that we're adding up, plus the sum of all of the horizontal chords in the polygon, because if you think about it, the radius at each level is counted twice, so we need the sum of the entire chord at each level. And Archimedes has a very neat way of adding up these chords. So if we go back just to the circular cross-section with its inscribed polygon now and draw in the vertical diameter and connect these horizontal chords in a kind of zigzag pattern. What we produce now is a large number of right-angled triangles, each of which has half of one of the horizontal chords and a little bit of diameter as the two sides on either side of the right angle. And you can see that the angles are the same in these triangles just because there are so many parallel lines. Since these triangles are all similar, the ratio of the sides in any one of them is going to be equal to the ratio of the sum of the sides, summing across all, the whole set. So the sum of all of those horizontal chords divided by the sum of the various bits that make up the diameter. And probably the easiest triangle to work with as our sort of sample triangle to get that ratio is ABZ in the diagram here. So what we end up with is that BZ over AB is equal to the sum of those horizontal chords divided by AZ. And so the total surface area of that inscribed shape turns out to be pi times the diameter times BZ. And BZ is, of course, just a little bit less than the diameter. So what we've got is a total surface area just a bit less than pi times the diameter squared, or 4 times the area of the circle that we rotated, which, of course, pi times the radius squared. And you can see how we're sort of getting towards the result here. If we consider exactly the same reasoning in the circumscribed shape, well, its surface area is going to be pi times its diameter times its equivalent of BZ. And Archimedes has another neat thought here that shows that B dash Z dash, now I'm adding dashes to show that we're in the outer polygon, that's actually the same as the diameter of the circle. If we contract the triangle A dash B dash Z dash by a factor of 2, centering at its A dash, B dash goes to the tangent point and Z dash goes to the center. So B dash Z dash therefore is twice the radius of the circle, or the diameter of it. Therefore, the surface area of this circumscribed shape is always more than pi times the diameter squared. Again, as Archimedes phrased it, 4 times the area of the circle that we rotated. So now that we have those guidelines, we can follow Archimedes' normal procedure to establish the surface area of the shape that's sandwiched, the sphere this time. And as usual, I'll go through this quite quickly because we've seen this in action many times. If the sphere's surface area were more than 4 pi times the radius squared, one would be able to construct an inscribed shape that's close enough that it too has a surface area that's more than 4 pi r squared. But we just saw that its surface area is always less than 4 pi r squared, so that would be a contradiction. Conversely, if the sphere's surface area were a bit less than 4 pi r squared, we could construct a circumscribed shape that would be close enough to the sphere that its area would also be less than 4 pi r squared, contradicting what we just established, but the fact that it's always a little bit more than 4 pi r squared. So by a process of elimination, we end up finding that the sphere's surface area is 4 pi times the radius squared. And that's how Archimedes derived this famous formula that we still use. I hope you enjoyed his proof. So far, we have only tackled surface areas, but on the sphere and cylinder also demonstrates the volume of a sphere in terms of the radius, and this is what we'll move on to in the next video. I hope you'll join me.